Hello, Preppers Prepper here. We're going to continue our series on knots. Now we're going to go to a hitch. Let's start off with the clove hitch. I'll show you three ways to tie the clove hitch. One way is to make a loop in your rope one direction, and then a second loop the opposite direction. So if you'll see, this loop is in front of the rope, whereas this loop is on the back side of the rope. When you slide these over each other, that'll make your clove hitch. You can slide it over an object and tighten it up. Looking at the top, you'll see from the working end, you've got basically two full wraps around the object with each leg coming out a different direction. That's what a clove hitch looks like when finished without a safety. Another way to tie the same knot is, another thing I do is I reach palms down, arms crossed over, holding the rope like this, grasp the rope, and keeping my palms down and my knuckles forward, and make one circle. All I did right there is make my two loops, one on each side of the rope, and then I slide them over each other. And there it is, same exact thing. Palms down, grasp it, do your nice little circle. There's your clove hitch again. Slide it over my object, tie it so you can see it. Looks like a clove hitch. Then all we'd have to do is finish up with a safety knot. And lastly, if your object is fixed and you are unable to tie it in that method, you have to literally feed the rope over, is how you would do so. I'll go ahead and set it maybe like this. You can see whatever the object happens to be. We'll say we're going to tie a clove hitch to hoist this object. I'm going to go around the object on one side of the rope on the running end, and with my working end, I'm going to go to the other side of the rope, and I always grasp here, make a little V so I have a notch to feed my rope through. Once it's fed through, there's my clove hitch. Again, same knot. To finish off, we can tie an overhand safety here. Boom. Or we can go around the direction that the rope is already going and tie our overhand safety. Little pretzel. Boom, right there. And what I do is I usually work this until it's good and tight, and that overhand safety butts up against the rest of my knot, and that's a really good tight knot. Good thing about a clove hitch is not only can you pull straight out with it, you can also pull in line when it's tied in line with an object. Either direction, if you pull against this lay, it actually pushes down on that. So if you tie it directionally, it does grab better in one direction than the other. Then, say we're going to hoist and we have a clove hitch and we want to hoist this object this way, I'll go ahead and throw in a half hitch, which is just a turn of the rope. That half hitch will grab a second time. We've got our knot that's going to hold definitively here, and then the half hitch is just going to give us a second bite on this guy. And if I was going to hoist something like an axe, I'd want to work that up towards the neck so it's less likely for it to come off if I hit something and get a little slack or whatever. But that's a means of hoisting. Now you know both the clove hitch and the half hitch.